This is African American History Month, and we're continuing to honor our trailblazers. For the last 2 weeks, we've reviewed significant contributions made by African American trailblazers. Today, we continue to look at trailblazers who have shaped Dallas. In 1967, Cleophas Anthony C.A. Galloway was the first appointed African American council member by J. Eric Johnson, who was then mayor. Mr. Galloway was a realtor and co-partner in a real estate firm from 1905 to 1995. In 1969, George L. Allen was the first elected African American council member, serving from 1968 to 1975. He was the president of a life insurance firm and a certified public accountant from 1909 to 1991. He played a role in the desegregation of Dallas schools and public facilities. The George L. Allen Courts building downtown is named for him. The first African-American supervisor and trainer of teachers was Jenny Tyler Brashear. She retired from Dallas ISD in 1967 after working in the field of education for 47 years. The Jimmy T. Brashear Elementary School is named for her. The first African-American chief of police was Terrell Bolton. Five Cornerstone Church members have been honored as our trailblazers, and today the list continues to grow. Our trailblazer for today is Christine McClanahan. Ms. McClanahan was born in Emerson, Arkansas, to the parents of Chesterfield and Zanny Blanks. Her children are Verna, Charlotte, and Bilvia. Her siblings are Mary, Claudia, Jerlene, Darlene, Lenora, Betty, Georgia, and one brother, Hiawatha. Her education was in the Emerson School District. She retired from the Scottish Rite Children's Hospital. Her ministries are the Cornerstone Usher Board, the daycare, and the homeless service. She assists with putting together the welcome bags. Her favorite quote, "Do you want me to tell you the truth?" Her favorite scripture is John 3:16. Her hobbies are serving the homeless and spending time with family. Her advice to children is, remember, a lie is easily told. Mrs. Clanahan, would you please come forward?
In my days, you always showed respect, and you didn't
wait for your elders to come to you. You went to them. That's my advice to children.
Oh, okay, so.
Ms. McClanahan, may God's love, grace, and mercy continue to keep you in perfect peace. We honor you this morning. We thank you so much, Cornerstone members, for giving us this time, and continue to show love and be of service to someone rather than wait on them to ask you to do something.
All right, thank you. Pat.